What is up, my shredheads? Welcome back to the channel. This is CES 2024. And
Madge, next time you come in, walk in backwards.
CES 2024, Las Vegas. Our first stop is going to be Segway. So let's get over there.
We actually have several things shared between these two models.
Yeah.
Like the intelligent things, smart features, like the mechanic locks, you can remote with your smartphone pairings.
Oh, okay.
And we can have a real-time GPS location.
Yes.
At your phones. And we also have some like dynamic power output.
Okay.
According to the perception of the vehicle.
Right.
He knows.
It knows what you're riding and what terrain like you're riding.
So
you're going to be able to feel a little bit of difference like when it's changing.
Based on this whole intelligent systems we merge together, we actually adapt it to different audience, to target audience. So the Xafari is more like an everyday usage bike. As you can see, it's more like a bicycle base.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, so like we'll step through e-bike. Yeah.
And we find the balance between the wise of and the comfort of the full suspension systems.
It's the first time I've ever seen a bike like this with suspension on it. That's pretty cool.
We just want to put a micro suspension here.
Yeah.
And semi-integrated in the frame. As you can see, this frame doesn't have any weldings.
Very smooth, very clean looking, you know what I mean?
We're using a very unique process called gravity casting.
Oh, okay.
So this frame is actually come out in one piece.
That is really cool. So it's going to be really durable, very strong.
Right. So yeah, it's very strong. And also we can achieve some like surface features.
Okay.
That is very hard to achieve with a traditional welding and tubing process.
Right. What's this here?
Magic cabin here.
Magic?
It's a quick adjust system.
Oh, wow.
It's very easy to adjust.
That makes life a lot easier.
Very easy.
What's the top speed on this bike?
Both of them. Class 2 e-bike,
okay.
So means 20 miles per hour top speed.
Okay, and then off-road mode?
We can tell now.
Okay.
Xyber, as you can see, it's really a motorcycle
style. Yes, I love this.
Street bike, very fast and very strong about the accelerations.
Yeah.
And it has used a half grip.
Half twist.
Throttle.
I love that.
So give you a very best performance on the acceleration and the control and the
sizes. Love the battery setup. Is this a 52 volt?
It's a 48 volts.
And I noticed you guys went with the direct drive hub motor. That's awesome. I like that.
Right. Torque is nearly 175 newton meters.
175 newton meters.
175.
Oh my god! Yeah. So that's gonna have some pretty good power.
What's more exciting is actually we originally equipped with only one battery, right?
Okay.
And you can put another one. You can add another one.
So there's another spot for another battery right here.
Yeah, for one battery, the capacity is 1440 watt hours.
Wow.
With two, it's nearly 3000.
So you got like a moped motorcycle right there. Right. You can get around anywhere you want to go.
Even more is after you have a second battery, we will have 30% more.
Okay.
Acceleration.
Oh, really? It gives you more power.
Yeah, it is.
Is there a torque sensor or is there a cadence sensor for the pedal assist? Or do you?
It's not finalized yet.
Okay.
For sure, we can tell that one is a torque sensor.
Torque sensor. You need it. Yeah, you need it for something like that for sure. And then what do you guys got going on for the tires? Is that a custom tire from Segway?
It is custom tires.
I love the look of it.
It's a 5-inch tires. You cannot find any other 5-inch tires.
20x5?
20x5.
20x5, yeah. And a big, I want to say that looks like a, I don't even know, 2-3,000 watt motor back there.
It actually is more powerful than it looks.
Yeah.
So later on, you can try on the outside.
Oh yes, I'm excited to try it. Look how thick that is, man.
That would be a lot of electricity goes through it.
Right. Yeah, so you can push a lot of power through this bike. 20 miles an hour for now. I'm thinking this is probably going to top out
and
50 miles an hour plus.
As you see, we have some sensors here.
Okay.
We have a sensor here, also one sensor on the saddle, because we want the users to be safe with these bikes. So sometimes you accidentally push the throttle.
Whiskey throttle.
Yeah. So with this sensor and this one, it actually knows you leave the bike.
Oh, so if you hop off and somebody comes up and the cockpit, everything looks familiar to me from like the GT2 scooter.
Right.
Feels very familiar. So they got an X on the front and rear for the headlight and taillight. So there's the X on the Xafari. What is it going to retail for?
We will release later this season.
Okay. Are you guys going to have a lower price point for the early adopters?
Yeah, for sure. Okay. For sure. Yeah.
Awesome. The next stop is going to be, we're going to test this thing out. We're going to see what it's all about. So, Felix, thank you so much for letting me know all about these two bikes, and I can't wait to test them out, brother. Yeah.